It was a day of high drama in the George Zimmerman trial, closing arguments. And prosecutors gave it all they had, trying to convince a jury of six people that Zimmerman is guilty of murder or manslaughter in the death of Trayvon Martin. Zimmerman, normally stoic, finally showed a silent reaction. And ABC's Matt Gutman was there.
It was a closing argument laden with emotion.
A teenager is dead. He is dead through no fault of his own. He is dead because another man made assumptions.
And theatrics.
Oh, he's skipping away. La, la, la. That's what he's claiming.
Prosecutor Bernie Della Rianda had George Zimmerman's credibility in the crosshairs, suggesting he lied about screaming for help that night.
Why is he able to yell if the defendant claims the victim was... How's he going to talk? Or is he lying about that?
Della Rianda using PowerPoint, this foam mannequin, and Zimmerman's own words to try to convince the jury that Zimmerman murdered Trayvon Martin for the way he looked.
He automatically assumed that Trayvon Martin was a criminal.
And again today, jurors shown pictures of Martin's body.
This is one of the last photos that will ever be taken of Trayvon Martin. And that is true because of the actions of one individual, the man before you, the defendant, George Zimmerman.
One juror turned away. Another seemed to nod in agreement as Della Rianda ripped into Zimmerman's credibility.
Do you believe that there is an innocent man sitting over there right now?
And throughout, Zimmerman stared blankly. His lawyer's chairs swiveled towards the prosecutor. His pointed straight ahead, barely moving until this moment.
The man before you, the defendant, George Zimmerman, the man who is guilty of second-degree murder.
Now, Diane, you saw Zimmerman there looking almost detached. His attorney tells me that he is under immense pressure. He knows his life is permanently changed. If he's convicted, he could spend the rest of his life behind bars. If he's acquitted, his attorney says, he could spend the rest of his life in hiding, only a semi-free man. Diane?
Thanks so much, Matt. And with that in mind, I want to bring in ABC's chief legal analyst, Nightline anchor Dan Abrams, following this case from the start. So should George Zimmerman be worried tonight? How worried?
He should absolutely be worried. It's still an uphill battle for prosecutors, but this was a very effective closing argument, focusing on an issue we discussed last night, which is the human aspect of this, the emotional aspect of this, the notion that this is a 17-year-old kid who didn't need to die. And it is possible that jurors will simply look at that issue alone and say, all right, the letter of the law is one thing, but the practical reality is another, and this is a kid who shouldn't be dead.
Something wrong happened.
That's right.
So manslaughter is a possible charge now. This was new today, right?
That's right. That's a big win for the prosecution, allows jurors to compromise, the difference being that in one case, murder, you have to show the intent to kill. In another case, it could just be a reckless, extremely negligent killing.
And again, for the jury, we're talking about six people. They're all female. And tomorrow, what will happen?
The defense is going to get an opportunity to give its closing argument. They're both going to have to respond to what they already heard and move forward with their own argument, knowing that the prosecution will have the final word. Each side gets 3 hours, but the prosecution gets to break it up, getting the first word and the last word because they have the burden of proof.
Okay, Dan Abrams, thank you once again tonight.